My dear friends, that which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone, and there is salvation in no one else. So following on from last week's healing, which inspired Peter to proclaim the gospel, the authorities, the religious establishment, haul the two disciples before them, demanding that they give an account for themselves. The establishment is alarmed. Here is something new and powerful that they are not in charge of. What is to be done? Again, Peter's response is to declare the gospel. Jesus of Nazareth was raised from the dead. Salvation is in him alone. And Peter then quotes Psalm 118, which contains these two verses. The stone that the builders rejected has now become the cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing, and it is wonderful to see. Peter is asserting the primacy of God over against the authority of the religious establishment. The stone that the builders rejected, the person that the religious authorities rejected, is the stone on which the master builder establishes salvation. Christ is the cornerstone. Now, just for those who don't fully appreciate the reference, the cornerstone was the massive block that was placed at the corner of a large building, like the temple, from which all the walls took their strength. A cornerstone of the temple is still there in Jerusalem. It's 40 foot long, 15 feet wide, 12 foot tall, and weighs around 600 tons. Truly, it is massive. And it's massive in order to provide stability and strength to everything that is built up on it. This is who Jesus is. He is the cornerstone of the new temple. When Jesus says that not one stone of this temple will be left upon another, he is describing not just the physical destruction of the temple by the Romans that happened in the generation after the crucifixion. He is also stating that the religious system centered upon that physical temple will also come to an end, and that he will replace it. This is the new covenant in my blood, says Jesus. The system of sacrifice centered on the temple in Jerusalem has become corrupt. The establishment is only concerned to keep the show on the road and has lost sight of the need to bring the people to God. Instead of a free access to a gracious God enabling reconciliation, now there are stumbling blocks placed in the way of the vulnerable, the broken, the lonely. Jesus turns over the tables of this system, and he begins something new, something centered upon a person, not a place. And at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth. For God has given no other name under heaven by which we must be saved. Jesus is the massive stone that provides the basis from which everything else is built. And what is built? It is the church that is built, the body of Christ built from the body of Christ. Christ is the foundation for all that we can do. And any good that we do, any healing or reconciliation, this is done in his name. So let's place our weight upon him and him alone and build our church today. Until we meet again. Amen.